Hello and welcome. So today we will be talking about Ethereum and DApp. So what is Ethereum? Ethereum is basically based on a blockchain network. So what is a blockchain network? A blockchain network or a blockchain technology is maybe a collection of technologies, you can think. For example, a bit like it's a bag of Lego. From the bag you can take out different bricks and put them together in different ways to create different results. So what is the difference between a blockchain and a normal database? Very loosely, a blockchain is a package which contains a normal database plus some software that adds new rows, validates the new rows to confirm the pre-agreed rules and listens, and broadcasts new rows to its peers across a network, ensuring that all peers have the same data in the database. So, what you can do with Ethereum? Obviously, you can trade coins, exchange coins for your money, and when a price increases or decreases there, you can just gain some benefit out of it. But what is else? So that's why I was talking about DApp. DApp is basically a decentralized application. So Ethereum is not just a cryptocurrency, but also a platform where you can build decentralized applications. So you might have heard of something like a smart contract transaction or something. So what is the term smart contract? Smart contract is just a phrase used to describe computer code that can facilitate the exchange of money, content, property, shares, or anything of value when running on the blockchain. Or a smart contract becomes like a self-operating computer program that automatically executes when specific conditions are met. Because smart contract runs on the blockchain, they run exactly as programmed without any possibility of censorship, downtime, fraud, or any third-party interference. So you might be wondering, how do I do all of this? Is it very hard or something? Obviously, you need some skills, programming skills. Also, you need something called as a smart wallet or Ethereum wallet for the programming. So we use here Solidity for programming. So you need to download the Ethereum wallet. So you might be wondering, how do I build an application on this? So basically, you need something like this Ethereum wallet. So what does this wallet do? It helps you to store your Ethereum coins and also to build some specific applications. In the start, you just have to do basic smart contracts. You can write a small program for it. Also, we can do a lot of things like issuing a token. So that is basically what is a token. A token is something that can be used as a currency to represent an asset, a virtual share, a proof of membership, or anything at all. So how do you issue a token? For that we will be talking later, not today. So you need to obviously learn Solidity for smart contracts. So we'll be talking more about blockchain. So here, blockchains have the ability to process code, but they are severely limited. Why Ethereum is different? So basically, rather than giving a set of limited operations, Ethereum allows developers to create whatever operations they want. This means that developers can build thousands of different applications that go way beyond anything that we have seen before. So you might be wondering, how to do all this? So basically, there's something called Mist and Ethereum wallet. Mist is pure for development, and Ethereum wallet is also, you can just do basic development, plus you can store your coins. So it comes for Windows, Linux, and macOS, which you can download from the GitHub website or the ethereum.org website, which link is there in the description. So what can be Ethereum used for? Basically, it can be used to build and deploy decentralized applications. A decentralized application or a dApp serves some particular purpose to its users. Bitcoin, for example, is a dApp that provides its users with peer-to-peer electronic cash system that enables online Bitcoin payments. Because decentralized applications are made up of code that runs on a blockchain network, they are not controlled by any individual or central entity. So what are the benefits of decentralized application? As there's no central point of failure and it is secured using cryptography, applications are well protected against hacking attacks and fraudulent activities. Any services that are centralized that can be also decentralized using Ethereum. Think about all the intermediary services that exist across hundreds of different thousand industries. From obvious services like loan provided by banks to intermediary services rarely thought about by most people, like title registers, voting system, regulatory compliance, and much more. So There's also a different website where you can just go check out the apps being built on the Ethereum network. Like here's a website, State of the Apps. So here you can just see lots and lots of applications which are built currently built on the Ethereum platform. So some of the apps are live and some are work in progress. So you can just go there and check their website out to find more about them. You can. Why I'm telling this is because you can also get your own idea to build different things out of it. So this is a very good website. Also, it's good to check out the Ethereum GitHub, where you can find lots and lots of different applications which are currently being built, and you can get an idea of your own to build your own app. So Ethereum can also be used to build something called decentralized autonomous organizations. So what is a DAO? It is fully autonomous, decentralized organization with no single leader. Generally, in any DApp, we do have a single leader which controls everything. No other third party can control, but a single developer who has built the application can control. But here, there is no single leader. DAOs are run by programming code on a collection of smart contracts, so which is written obviously on the Ethereum blockchain. The code is designed to replace the rule and structure of a traditional organization, so it eliminates the need for people and centralized control. A DAO is owned by everyone who purchases tokens. So basically, purchasing token is something currency, you purchase some value. So you can also have a particular share in that market. So instead of each token equating to equity shares and ownership, tokens act as contributions that give people voting rights. So basically, when you purchase these tokens, you don't get the equal share, but you have something called the voting right. You are basically contributing something to that blockchain network. So here is another website, bloggeeks.com, where you can just get to know about how Ethereum came into existence, how decentralized applications work, what are the benefits, and what are also some of the bad thing about it. So I would just be telling about you can think about what are the benefits of the decentralized platform. So first one is immutability, obviously, because a third party cannot make any changes to the data. It's corruption and tamper proof. It is secure, well protected against hacking attacks. Also, one major advantage is there, which is zero downtime. Apps can never go down and can never be switched off because it's on the blockchain network and it's not particularly stored in a single computer or a server which you can just shut down and it'll go away, which will not happen. That's a very huge benefit. So you might be wondering, what is the downside of the decentralized applications? So despite bringing a number of benefits, decentralized applications aren't faultless. So, because smart contracts code is written by humans, smart contracts are only as good as the people who write them. Code bugs or oversight can lead to unintended adverse actions being taken. If a mistake in the code gets exploited, there is no efficient way rather than rewriting the underlying code. So, this goes against the essence of the blockchain, which is meant to be immutable. Also, any action taken by a central party raises serious questions about decentralized nature of an application. So this was just the introduction of the Ethereum and DApp. If you want to try and build your own application on the Ethereum platform, so you can just check the description where some of the sites which I had showed you are there below.